Welcome, guys.
Hello. I love you back.
Thank you.
I love you too, Kyle. And I've seen you naked.
If you guys aren't on Vine yet, get on Vine and check out what they posted on Vine, okay? New social media. These guys
right
are hilarious.
Here. Then you can all see Kyle naked. No. Partially.
All right, real quick before you guys do your thing, one of the things that we heard about the album when you were making it was that you guys lived in a cabin in Nashville. Now, who was there and what was that experience like?
Well, live is probably a strong word.
Yeah. We drank.
I live in Nashville.
We drank in the cabin.
Everybody kind of flew in and flew out. So it was like this revolving cast of who was actually staying there at any given time. But yeah, it was kind of just an effort to get back to, that feeling that we had when we made the first album, because we all lived in a condo together, and you know, we were just so immersed in the music because we were, you know, physically together every morning getting up, and so if there was an idea, it's like you were going to realize it right then and there. So that was kind of the idea for you know by doing it.
And you had to get everything done by dinner time, because after dinner time when the wine opened up, everything
yeah,
just got
yeah.
And then
yeah,
once we. Everything we wrote, we thought was genius, you know, like, and the next day we'd run back to the studio, like, let's listen to it. And it was always just like, yeah. Like, a, you know, an hour of tape of us going.
And after a while, like all the runners, you know, just knew to get twice as much alcohol as we actually asked them to get, you know, just so they wouldn't have to run
totally,
out again.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. But you know what? But to be fair, they were drunk, too. Like. You was going to tell me they were working at the studio, and the guys that were working at the studio were like hammered by 8 o'clock. They're just like, yes.
It was kind of like this.
Push the record button. You're fine.
Yeah, everybody were like hippies. There was a lot. What was that movie with Jennifer Aniston and
Wanderlust.
Yeah, Wanderlust. It was a little bit of that, like without the naked people. But they were like, all these guys were like Grateful Dead fans. If it seemed so, yeah.
And then it became a little like Lord of the Flies.
So they were just. They didn't know how to run anything either. They were just kind of hanging out with us.
Now, you live there, Kyle, right? Nashville?
Yeah, that's where I call home, yes.
Is there something about that area with just the music vibe that's kind of like a muse for you guys? Did you feel that way?
I think some really good songs came from a lot of the work that we did in Nashville, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, not a lot. Not as much in the cabin, really, because we did a lot. Most of the writing happened, like, we would spend a week in L.A. at Paul's studio, because we live all over. So we'd be at my place in New York for a week, and then we'd be at Kyle's place in Nashville for a week. And then when you're done, you've got like 40 or 50 song ideas. And then when you got to Nashville, that whole thing was just about kind of taking those and like being honest with yourself and figuring out which ones just weren't good and which ones, you know, were worth kind of working on. And then after we did that for a few months, then we went to LA and actually started kind of really making the record.
Sure. Right. All right, guys. I'm going to let you guys go for it. What's the first song you're going to play?
We'll do She's So Mean.
Perfect.
I know a girl, she gets what she wants all the time, 'cause she's fine. But for an angel, she's a hot, hot mess, make you so blind, but you don't mind. 'Cause she's an uptown, get around, anything goes, girl, girl. She's a hardcore candy store, give me some more, girl. Yeah, she'll make you take her to the club, but then she leaves with her friends. She likes to stay late at the party, 'cause the fun never ends. And all her clothes are on the floor, and all your records are scratched. She's like a one-way ticket, 'cause you can't come back. Saying yeah, you want her, but she's so mean, you'll never let her go. Why don't you let her go? Yeah, want her, but she's so mean, you'll never let her go. Why don't you let her go? You know that if you don't shut your mouth, she'll freak out. You better get yourself together, 'cause she's bringing you down now. Yeah, boy, you better, cause she's an uptown, get around, anything goes, a girl, girl. She's a hardcore candy store, give me some more, girl, girl. She's got a wicked sense of humor, can't believe what she says. She drinks Bacardi in the morning till it goes to her head. And all you want is just to hold her, but she don't go for that. She has a hard time coming when she can't hit back, saying, yeah, you want her, but she's so mean.
You'll never let her go, why don't you let her go,
yeah. You want her, but she's so mean.
You'll never let her go, why don't you let her go?
Every now and then she makes you just a little bit crazy, crazy. She'll turn the knife into your back and then she's calling you baby, crazy. Yeah, you want her, but she's so mean.
You'll never let her go, why don't you let her go?
Yeah, you want her, but she's so mean.
You'll never let her go, why don't you let her go?
Yeah, man, I know how you want her,
want her.
Yeah, man, I know how you want her,
want her.
Yeah, man, I know how you want her, but she's so mean.
You'll never let her go, why don't you let her go?
Thank you. You know what I love? Okay, with that song, there is, I sing the line, like, you tell a lot about people when you're singing a song, and like I sing the line, if you don't shut your mouth, she'll freak out, and she looks over and she's like, yeah, yeah, and then I sing the line about drinking Bacardi in the morning, and she's like, yeah. I already know a little bit about both of you now.
So Rob, is that song about somebody in particular, or is it just kind of like somebody that we all know that girl?
Can't really be someone in particular because me, Paul, and Kyle all wrote it together, and we don't party like that. So,
we don't like Bacardi really. So that's, I think is what we mean.
But no, I think, you know, I just think everybody's kind of had that. Like guys and girls both, I think, have, for some reason, like if the heart or the genitals are concerned, people can make bad decisions, even very smart people, and like still stay with things that they know are really bad for them. You know.
Now, so on the album, it was. You guys did like a lot of collaborative,
true story.
A lot of collaborative work. Like you, Kyle, you did a lot of the writing too. Is that how it worked out?
Yeah, I mean, I was definitely more involved. I think over the course of the last two records, more of the band members kind of got involved in the songwriting. I think this time was an effort to. I'm liking that too, by the way. It was a beautiful time that we spent together. Oh, yes, it was. Two hearts, sometimes three, beating as one. That's how it happens. And that's how it happens.
That's perfect.
Need I say more?
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, but you know, it's funny because we did, for the first time in a long time, we had, like, there's songs on here that, like, me and Paul wrote, and there's songs that me and Paul and Kyle wrote, and songs that Kyle wrote alone, and Paul wrote alone, and I wrote. So it's a real kind of mixture of everything. Yeah. There's a song that Paul and Kyle wrote that mm-hmm. Kyle sings, a song called The Way on the record.
Yeah. Woo! I mean, I've said this a lot, but I really do, like, we're huge U2 fans, and it can't be ignored that. What? You guys like you too, right?
They're not going to show up. Yeah, no, okay, calm down.
No, but I mean, it couldn't be ignored that we talked a lot about like their process, and because we worked with Steve Lillywhite on the Exile sessions,
produced a lot of the U2 stuff.
Yes, and so that was kind of an eye-opening experience for us, and we learned a little bit about their process, and so I think that inspired a little bit of the idea of like, hey, let's let's, you know, not necessarily the cabin wasn't necessarily that experience, but the idea of us getting together. I mean, Rob is a fantastic songwriter. We all know this. But the idea of the band finding its voice also in the writing process, you know. But I think we're all really honest with each other, too. It was all like the best song has to be on the album. So, I mean, we weren't going to, like, can songs because we all wrote it together. This is awesome, man. It was jam. It was great.
All right, real quick. You're going out on tour with the Goo Goo Dolls?
Yeah.
Do you guys have any plans to pull some kind of prank on them? Because I heard about what you guys did to Philip Phillips.
I don't know. I guess we have to gauge and see, like, what kind of sense of humor Johnny Goo has, because I'm not really, you know? Otherwise, I mean, we just might just be very nice to each other, I guess. I mean, we've had some really good times pulling some pranks with Sugar Ray and Fountains of Wayne, and some things have gotten pretty dark and deep and naked.
Yeah. Check Vine again. Yeah. All right, I'm going to let you guys go ahead and take it off.
Okay.
Well, she said it's cold outside and she hands me my raincoat. She's always worried about things like that. She said it's all gonna end and it might as well be my fault. And she only sleeps when it's raining. And she screams, but her voice is straining. She says, baby, it's 3 a.m., I must be lonely. Well, she says, baby, and I can't help but be scared of it all sometimes. But the rain's gonna wash away, I believe it. She's got a little bit of something. God, it's better than nothing. And in her color portrait world, she believes that she's got it all going on. She swears the moon don't hang as quite as high as it used to. And she only sleeps when it's raining. And she screams until her voice is straining. She says, baby, if it's 3 a.m., I must be lonely. Yeah, when she says, baby, well, I can't help but be scared of it all sometimes. But the rain's gonna wash away, I believe. God help me, I believe this. Well, she believes her life is made up of all that she's used to. And the clock on her wall has been stuck at 3 for days and days and days. She thinks that happiness is a map that sits on her doorway. Yeah, but outside it stopped raining. Yeah, she says, baby, it is 3 a.m., I must be lonely. And yeah, when she says, baby, yeah, well, I can't help but be scared of it all sometimes. But the rain's gonna wash away, I believe this. When it's 3 a.m., I must be lonely.
I must be lonely.
Yeah, when she says, baby, then I can't help but be scared of it all sometimes.
Thank you, thank you. The new single on the record is a song called Our Song, and we didn't realize it when you write it, but this meant that we were going to be going out and doing radio interviews, and you'd have to, like, you announce your song, and so you'd have to be like, this is our song.
I don't know why sometimes we seem so apart, sewn together with a broken heart. I try to see you, but it's getting dark. Words keep flowing out, I wonder what they mean. You're like a little piece of kerosene. Girl, you've always been a friend to me, and I've been too proud sometimes, chasing fault lines. Oh no, I'm gonna be there always. After the pain has gone away, the feelings are so strong. This can be our song. This can be our song. Oh no, I'll never make you cry again. I'm gonna set things right again, and I won't let them go wrong. This can be our song. This can be our song. And I don't know if someone else could handle me, 'cause I don't know what I'm supposed to be. And you're the only one who really sees. You get me. I feel something growing deep inside of me, and what I say and what I mean always seem to disagree. So help me through these hard times, change these fault lines. Oh no, I'm gonna be there always. Has gone away, the feelings are so strong. This can be our song. This could be our song. Oh no, I'll never make you cry again. I'm gonna set things right again, and I won't let them go wrong. This can be our song. This could be our song. Whoa, whoa. This can be our song. This could be our song. Oh no, I'll never make you cry again. I'm gonna set things right again, and I won't let them go wrong. This can be our song. This could be our song. Oh, oh, be our song. This could be our song. Oh no, this could be our song. Oh no, oh no, this could be our song. This could be our song.
Thank you. This next song is from we had it on an album called More Than You Think You Are, and it was the first single from that record. And we were so behind the gun on that we were actually, I remember we were in the studio in New York and finishing the record while we were listening to the song on the radio and just thinking, oh, we're screwed, like this isn't gonna happen. So I wrote this song with Mick Jagger. We wrote two songs together, and one wound up on his solo record, and this one wound up on our record. And it happened because he called my house, and I get this message, and I wasn't home, and he left it on my machine. And it was like, you know, hey, Rob, I think this song, the Disease song, I think is much better with your voice. I think you guys should do that, and I'll do this other song. So I kept that message on my machine for like a couple years, right? And then I would just keep it there. And then whenever somebody would come over to my house, I would be like, well, hell, let me check the messages, see if anybody called. And you come over, and I'd come over, and I'd hit the button, and be like, dude, hey, Rob. And I'd be like, oh, it's Mick again.
It's like, no, you don't have to wait in the foyer. Just come on in the kitchen.
Yeah, just come on in the kitchen. Right, stand right here next to the, while I check this. So yeah, no, I'm not above that.
Feels like you made a mistake. You made somebody's heart break. Now I have to let you go. I have to let you go. You left a stain on every one of my good days. But I am stronger than you know. And I have to let you go. 'Cause no one's ever turned you over. No one's tried to ever let you down. Beautiful girl, bless your heart. I got a disease deep inside me, makes me feel uneasy, baby. I can't live without you. Tell me, what am I supposed to do about it? Keep your distance from it. Don't pay no attention to me. I got a disease. Like you're making a mess, yeah. Your hell on wheels in a black dress. You drove me to the fire and left me there to burn. And every little thing you do is tragic. All my life before was magic. Beautiful girl, I can't breathe. I got a disease deep inside that makes me feel uneasy, baby. I can't live without you. Tell me, what am I supposed to do about it? Keep your distance from it. Don't pay no attention to me. I got a disease, yeah, well, I think that I'm sick. But leave me be while my world is coming down on me. You taste like honey, honey. Tell me, can I be your honey? Be strong. I'm telling myself that it won't take long till I'm free of my disease. Free of my disease. Free of my disease. Oh no, oh no. I got a disease deep inside me, makes me feel uneasy, baby. I can't live without you. Tell me, what am I supposed to do about it? Keep your distance from it. Don't pay no attention to me. I got a disease, yeah, well, I think that I'm sick. But leave me be while my world is coming down on me. You taste like honey, honey. Tell me, can I be your honey? Be strong. I'm telling myself that it won't take long till I'm free of my disease. Hey, well, free of my disease. Set me free of this disease. Oh, yeah.
we that was our San Jose outro.
A little ditty off the new record. This is probably one of my favorites. It's like a band favorite. This is actually a song about a couple late in their life. Have been together maybe 60 years, and one of them has Alzheimer's and is starting to forget their life, and the other person is trying to remind them, you know, every day, little by little, just to kind of remember who they were. This is a song called I Will. Tonight, looking back on all this life, it's funny how the time goes by, and how sometimes it slides away. In time, sliding through the dead of night, you shake until you start to cry. Your eyes won't dry till light of day. Then sleep away, don't let it go. Don't let it fade. Your dreams may cave, and falling apart is the only way we go so low. When you don't know, I will. If you go, just take a little piece of me and hang it by the place you sleep and dream of me. Don't leave, just sleep anyway. Don't let it go. Don't let it fade. Your dreams may cave, and falling apart is the only way we go so low. When you don't know, I will. Tonight, looking back on all this life, it's funny how the time goes by, and how sometimes it slides away. Thank you guys so much for coming tonight. I really appreciate that. Thank you. Right? That, ladies and gentlemen, is why we got into a band.
Honky tonk, but don't get...
What? I don't know what happened to you, man, after Nashville. Just everything started sounding like this. I will.
What are we doing now?
If I fall along the way, but pick me up and dust me off. And if I get too tired to make it, be my breath so I can walk. If I need some other love, then just give me more than I can stand. And when my smile gets old and faded, wait around, I'll smile again. Shouldn't be so complicated. Just hold me and then just hold me again. Can you help me? I'm bent. I'm so scared that I'll never get put back together. Keep breaking me in, and this is how we will end.
How we will
with
end.
You and me bent. If I couldn't sleep, could you sleep? Could you paint me better off? Could you sympathize with my needs? I know you think I need a lot. I started out clean, but I'm jaded. Just phoning it in, just breaking the skin. Can you help me? I'm bent. I'm so scared that I'll never get put back together. We'll keep breaking me in, and this is how we will end.
How we will
with
end.
You and me. Yeah, you and me. You and me. We're bent. All of us bent. Start bending me. It's never enough till I feel all your pieces. And start bending me. Keep bending me on till I'm completely broken in. Shouldn't be so complicated. Just touch me and then, hey, touch me again. Can you help me? I'm bent. I'm so scared that I'll never get put back together.
keep breaking me in, and this is how we will end.
How we will
with
end.
You and me landing without understanding. Here I go there again. Can you help me? I'm bent. I'm so scared that I'll never get put back together. Hey, you're breaking me in, and this is how we will end, with you and me. Yeah.
Thank you guys so much, man. Have a great night.
Yes. Kyle, Rob, thank you guys so much. That was amazing. Thank you so much. Kyle and Rob from Matchbox 20.